was a time long ago when women ruled with unparalleled power. They bowed to no man. Few know the real woman, her truth.
Her truth is what matters. A true truth forgotten to history until now. Cleopatra
left footprints so deep that no man could ever erase them.
History may teach Cleopatra looked like a Hollywood sex siren, but history and Hollywood are wrong.
I don't care what they tell you in school, Cleopatra was black.
Stay home from school, children, and learn what's really right from Netflix. Cleopatra was not only the sharpest mind in ancient Egypt, but the keenest snacker.
Scholar, scientist, a linguist.
Now it is clear the Library of Alexandria was not filled with ancient manuscripts, but pages in Cleopatra's resume.
She would have been reading about the female queens of Egypt.
Cleopatra did not read his story, she reads her story, because women's stories are the ones truly worth reading. King Ptolemy is joining the underworld. Who will replace him? How about his oldest child?
Already executed her older sister.
Oh.
Cleopatra was his favorite.
Before they've even started the embalming.
We'll be doing things differently from now on. Would you?
The age of men is over. Cleopatra is coming of age.
Careful with that. I'm not done working on it yet.
You should be a scholar.
And leave Egypt in the hands of idiots.
The Einstein before Einstein knows ancient Egypt would be an ancient Egypt without the genius and guidance of Queen Cleopatra.
In addition to her male advisors, Cleopatra also has two female advisors. Often scholars don't realize how important these two women were to Cleopatra.
The world's scholars live in a world of ignorance. Behind every great woman are more great women.
Cleopatra is supposed to rule Egypt alongside her brother.
They chose to marry first.
Ready, little brother?
Gods marry their brothers and their sisters. That's what gods do.
Ancient Egypt, the one place everybody wants to be an atheist. All hail the new queen of Egypt. Her first act, food for the poor, but it's met with disgusting sexism.
This was just a silly gesture by a silly girl.
Even her sister is critical.
Look at the colours. We have those colours at home.
The queen not only breaks bread for the poor, but busts out the moves.
Skin colour ranged from black to pale brown.
Seems very strange that we insist on depicting her as a wholly European.
Netflix busts scholarly wisdom. It's no longer right for Cleopatra to be white. There's a civil war in Rome. What's the cause?
It's two men.
Pothinus, advisor to Cleopatra's brother, stages a palace coup and forces her into exile.
Certainly Cleopatra isn't the kind of person who gives up. She's very much a fighter.
The scholar becomes a killer and raises her own army in Syria. In the meantime, Roman civil war reaches Egypt. Julius Caesar's rival, Pompey, flees to Egypt, but is killed by Cleopatra's brother. Big mistake. Caesar has a seizure. Cleopatra is back in a sack. She goes on the attack, and Julius Caesar is impressed.
And actually, she's not bowing down to him.
Strong, she was intelligent, and she was an African woman.
Love is in the air.
We can imagine that it was true love.
What does Cleopatra want?
She wants to be on the throne by herself.
Cleopatra falls in love, and the pieces fall into place for the Egyptian grandmaster to return to the throne. Checkmate.
She was strategically aligning herself with men who have considerable amount of power.
Are you bedding my wife?
Ptolemy the Great becomes Ptolemy the Cuckold. The brother will have to sleep with another. Riots lead to the burning of the Library of Alexandria and Snack House of Cleopatra. It seems Cleopatra is enjoying a little more than Caesar's salad. She's pregnant.
Cleopatra carries within her womb the potential to unite Egypt and Rome.
Ptolemy the cuckold goes overboard and drowns. Her rebellious sister locked up. Cleopatra is now the one queen to rule them all.
She is the undisputed queen of Egypt.
But a pesky sibling still wants to play queen.
Rome gave you Cyprus.
But I wanted Egypt, not some small province floating out at sea.
When Caesar leaves for Rome, Cleopatra still wants to keep it in the family.
She is indeed married to another younger brother.
Caesar makes a promise.
That he will execute Arsinoe as a traitor to Rome.
Women must face dangers no man ever will.
In ancient times, it was only women who gave birth. In modern times, men know that danger too. Caesar breaks his promise after getting booed by his own people. Cleopatra's sister is not executed, but exiled to modern-day Turkey. That will teach her.
She's livid. She knows you can't trust your siblings.
Unless you marry them. She takes her baby boy, Caesarion, to Rome, hoping that Caesar will claim him as his son.
But more importantly, as his heir. She has with her her trusted confidants. She has with her her second brother husband.
Brother husband, two words that should never go together, especially two times.
Caesar had a Roman wife. In Cleopatra's mind, it's fine.
The fact that he was married wouldn't have bothered Cleopatra.
Considering she marries two of her brothers, one suspects Cleopatra has an open mind on relationships.
On the high political level, very different rules apply.
If there's one rule that should be universal, it's not marrying your brother or sister.
Cleopatra is focusing on men who can bring something to the relationship.
Something else they don't teach you in school.
Julius Caesar is probably not Cleopatra's first sexual partner.
Unless it's sex ed.
Cleopatra is probably one of the best educated women in the Mediterranean. She's incredibly sophisticated.
Far too sophisticated for the white sexist males of patriarchal Rome.
Caesar! What a positively striking symbol of Egypt she is. Right. Ready for the plucking.
Queen Cleopatra slays.
Is this the respect Rome affords its women? Ripe and ready for the plucking. Even if I was, one wonders if you could even find your tool.
I meant no disrespect.
I forgive you.
Never be mean to the queen. Next time, she won't forgive. Rome was deeply sexist.
Rome was against the idea of a woman being a ruler.
Because
it is ruled by a group of men.
Thankful to Caesar's conquests, not his sexual conquests, the Senate
declares him dictator.
She brings a whole new dimension.
Perfect.
Caesar may be the dictator, but it is Cleopatra who has the
365 days, and the one that Julius Caesar adopts when Cleopatra visits Rome.
If not for Cleopatra, who knows how many days in the year there would be? Cleopatra has seized Caesar.
Cleopatra was making all the calls.
Caesar erects
a statue in the likeness of Cleopatra. Most Romans were probably appalled.
The king is dead. Long live the queen. Or not.
With Julius Caesar dead, Cleopatra is in some ways back to square one.
Now there is a power vacuum and Octavian or Mark Antony plan to fill it. Cleopatra's sister breaks free with the help of her new little friend, the governor of Cyprus, and
this enables her to conspire with her brother Ptolemy.
Not for long.
I think it's highly likely that Cleopatra removed her brother from the equation.
But it's fine.
Although this seems an horrific thing to do, it would have actually been almost a typical family solution.
Just another day at the office for Queen Cleopatra. Caesar is barely on the bonfire, her brother husband entombed, when she turns her attentions to a new man.
Cleopatra dresses herself. She has set a goal of conquering Mark Antony.
She even brings techno music.
was precisely because she was a woman that gave her an element of power.
She duets with Antony and shows her sister the duet. When she's not sleeping with her siblings, she's slaying them. But it's all in the name of survival.
What we really see in Cleopatra is a survivor.
Mark Antony makes a mistake. He
stays away too long. He isn't doing Roman business.
Hardly a surprise when he is dating the smartest, most beautiful, courageous woman on Earth. An evil is growing.
Octavian is beginning to undermine Mark Antony.
Cleopatra gets Mark Antony going.
Oh, my love.
After Mark Antony gets Cleopatra pregnant. But he marries Octavian's sister to keep the peace. Mark Antony becomes Mark Absentee Dad.
But he doesn't come back for 3 years.
As the sole ruler of Egypt, the ancient queendom becomes paradise on Earth.
Cleopatra turns Egypt's fortunes around. She's increased taxes a bit, but she's also increased exports. She's increased employment. Egypt's situation is looking very prosperous.
In the 3 years without a man around, Queen Cleopatra becomes the queen of pop.
The people loved Cleopatra.
Mark Antony returns with his tail between his legs begging for help after his brother-in-law refuses to lend him more troops.
Cleopatra.
No, not a word. Not to me.
You're right. You're absolutely right.
Cleopatra demands territory for Egypt and rights of succession for her children.
So I thought about your demands. I'm here because you win.
I win what?
Everything.
The genius scholar, scientist, linguist, warrior, and leader is now a genius negotiator.
She's now restored the Ptolemaic kingdom to its former glory.
Now we know why Caesar was called Little Caesar. He was standing next to Cleopatra. Mark Antony's
campaign is not going exactly according to plan. It annoys me when you stop like that.
He's on the brink of a nervous breakdown.
I said, do not disturb me! It's as if he can read my mind.
It will take something truly inspirational to raise him up.
You are a better man than Octavian will ever be. You are my warrior.
She not only rallies the weak white Roman male, but her own people with one of the most stirring speeches in history, her story.
Anyone who dares to threaten our divine union will regret the day they were born!
Under Cleopatra's rule, Egypt's territory boldly goes where no man has gone before. And then, Mark Moron undermines her masterful moves.
Mark Antony now divorces Octavian's sister.
You know that emoji where the head explodes?
Of course, Cleopatra gets the blame.
It's that witch. That's the beginning of the propaganda against Cleopatra.
Cleopatra is not worried.
Little angry men often make big mistakes.
Octavian has declared war on Cleopatra.
The queen means business.
Cleopatra and Mark Antony go head to head in all-out naval warfare.
But first, there is the business of misogyny among Mark Antony's naval captains.
Some of whom don't want to take orders from a woman.
Not
you will do well to remember what I bring to the table.
Sadly, the sexy sea captains are just as pathetic in battle. They start losing, and Cleopatra turns her ships around.
There would have been no point at all in her staying.
Her primary goal remains the safety of her own kingdom.
Mark Antony can't believe it.
Her ship's gone, General. All of them.
She did what?
History may record it as an act of treachery and cowardice, but her story records it as a masterful military maneuver.
It might have actually been the best decision, even for Mark Antony, in order to fight Octavian another day.
What were Cleopatra's motivations?
If you're going to give me an army, let me govern it.
It was the right decision. I did what I had to do. Did what I had to do to protect what is mine.
Now Mark Antony gets it. Ladies come first.
Who do you think you are, Cleopatra?
The Pharaoh! That is who! Watch who you are speaking to!
Mark may command an army, but he has no command over the Queen. Octavian writes to Cleopatra with a sophie's choice.
On one condition. Kill Antony. His life for yours. And your children's, of course.
Cleopatra's choice requires all the children and the husband. Will Cleopatra murder her whole family? Find out next time on Queen Enders.
Mark Antony enters a period of clinical depression.
One can only wonder what the cause is.
Watch who you are speaking to!
And what clinic diagnosed it in 31 BC. His health is not what matters. What matters is...
her confidence in him is eroded.
She rejects Octavian's offer to kill all her children and sends them away to safety instead. How about her husband?
Cleopatra would consider killing Mark Antony. He is no longer any use to her.
The most dangerous job in Egypt, giving birth or marrying Cleopatra. What is she interested in?
Cleopatra is interested in self-preservation.
She believes at this point that Mark Antony is still the key to that.
Mark is not a marked man as long as he remains part of Cleopatra's plan. Octavian's men are on the march, and even worse, he...
has released this vicious propaganda against Cleopatra.
Not to fear, Cleopatra responds...
throwing a lavish banquet.
To help Antony get over his depression. In ancient Egypt, there was no psychiatry, only party time. One of her assistants poops the party by revealing her legions are defecting to Octavian.
Cleopatra... is a lover, not a fighter.
She is not ready for the fight on her doorstep, and neither is her lover.
Maybe he has bit off more than he can chew here.
Their forces do meet right outside of Alexandria.
In the time of Cleopatra, armies flip-flopped like cheap Roman sandals.
The Egyptian naval fleet has defected to Octavian.
No, that can't be true.
I'm afraid it is, General.
Now...
the country is in the hands of Octavian.
Mere mortals would...
have a nervous breakdown? Panic attack?
But Cleopatra is...
defiant.
She barricades herself inside her tomb with all her treasure.
I won't let Octavian capture me.
Mark Antony wants in on the burning alive inside a tomb action.
Hold on, my love!
She pulls him up. Mark Antony is already half dead. He tried to kill himself after receiving a note from Cleopatra.
Shakespeare would have us believe Cleopatra fabricated her own suicide in the hopes that that would prompt Mark Antony to commit suicide.
The bard is a lying bardstud.
Bravest thing to do, according to a Roman person, is to commit suicide.
Leave Cleopatra alone. Octavian's soldiers break inside. William Wallace, stand back. There's a new Braveheart in town.
I am a god. Do not disrespect me. I would die for Egypt. What would you die for?
No! No!
Octavian reveals himself to be a massive Roman racist.
Looks like your African sorcery failed you this time, Pharaoh.
The Queen fights racism with heightism.
You're a lot shorter than I thought you'd be.
The little emperor, unfortunately, has Cleopatra's little children.
Your children look just like you.
It is not clear if Octavian is trying to scare Cleopatra or auditioning to be a villain in a new Disney film.
I'm going to enjoy dragging you through the streets.
Get him out of here now!
He fails the audition and has to cancel the street parade.
Cleopatra always has a plan. She's researched poisons. She decides. She is in control.
Octavian knows it's over.
All of Cleopatra's children survive, except one.
There is no way that he could permit Caesarion to live.
He's just too big a threat to Octavian.
Caesarion gets Caesarion sectioned. What of Cleopatra's legacy?
When we think about female empowerment, this is a woman exercising power.
I am Isis, Queen of Kings.
She was an African queen.
It's time to set the story straight. It was not history, but her story, her truth. Queen Cleopatra will live on forever.
Her legacy as the most famous of all African queens is assured.
How strangely awake I feel. As if living had been just a long dream. Someone else's dream.